Duolingo Math. Let's get into it. Okay, you can sign in with your existing Duolingo account. I did that. I entered my age. Will not be showing that here, but they told me we recommend that adults do brain training. So that's why I said, okay, let's do it, because I don't need elementary math. Okay, so that's what I'm doing. You're setting up the account, the notifications. The last time I took a math class was more than 10 years ago. Let's just leave it at that. I did test out of math in college, so I did only take statistics, but again, it has been 10 years. So if I am a bit, you know, not the quickest with my math here, give me grace. Like here, I'm not sure why I took so long. I can't remember. But I think a lot of my issue or a lot of my speed issue when I'm doing this for the first time is just figuring out the interface and what they're trying to say or what they're trying to get me to input. So this is an exercise that is frequent throughout the coursework I ended up doing today thus far, and it's rounding each number to the nearest 10 and then doing math based on the nearest 10s. And that was like hard for me because just like, but the numbers themselves are right there. Why do I have to round to the nearest 10? And I don't know if that's the way that math was taught for people or whatever, as opposed to just doing out the numbers. So that took me a while to get a grasp on. And with that unit or that module of the unit done, I have now, quote, extended a streak, essentially created one. So each module has, I guess, 3 rounds that you do, and then you do each one, and when you finish a module in a unit, you get a star, which is the equivalent of the crown system. Even this graphic representation thing, instead of you just showing the answer in dots, it wants you to literally show the problem graphically, which is something else I had to figure out. So now I unlocked that module. It's golded. I thought that maybe by me golding the first in that unit. I would have all the previous modules golded. No, maybe I need to gold the whole unit. So that's what I end up doing. I don't know how many non-Americans will understand this reference, but would you believe me if I told you I got college credit for BC Calculus? Would you believe me? So I didn't think about it at the time, in terms of app usability, user friendliness, whatever, but looking back on it, I think that's one of the negatives of this app so far. Regular Duolingo, you can click on a word you don't know and you'll see the translation. They have these words highlighted and whatnot. That's not so much the issue. The issue I have is when it has you doing conversions. If you don't know off the top of your head certain conversions, you're kind of screwed. At some point they ask you to do a pounds to ounces, and it's just like, if you don't know, what are you supposed to do on this quick app? And yes, you could argue that, or I guess it should be argued that an adult should know these measurements. And I assume it's localized for the US, or I don't know if it's only available in the US right now, or the UK, whatever, localized to other countries or not. But I'm not using yardage on a regular basis. I'm only really using feet, okay? So why do, okay. Module complete, unit complete. Do I get to see? No, I do not get to see all of the preceding modules and units golded. That kind of defeats the purpose of the whole app, doesn't it? I guess, yes. So I do have this option to quote unquote speed round each of the skills or modules I've completed thus far. So that's what I'm doing here. So as opposed to this being a timed challenge, it really is just you trying to speedrun it and beat your own personal best. I don't think I'm going to be doing this so much. I'm just not a fast person on the tablet and whatnot. Again, I pose the question, would you believe me if I told you I got college credit for calculus? Would you believe me if I told you I graduated high school with like a special math degree? Would you believe that? I don't know that I would. So I did the speed round 3 times because it had the 3 boxes at the bottom, but why even keep the 3 best times? Just keep the 1? I'm not really sure why they decided to do that. That's interesting, okay. It does show you your best time under the module though. And so I started this, I downloaded the app around 10:30. It's 2 o'clock at this point. I've not been doing it straight like, oh my gosh, I'm just trying to run it super fast. I took a break and I did nothing. I was doing laundry today. But you see, I've already done 3 of 7 units. I don't think this will take long to complete. So I don't know if they're going to add more units. I don't know if they're going to make some other Duolingo where you can add friends or do challenges. I think challenges make sense here a lot more maybe than they do in Duolingo. But it's something to be seen. Anyway, I think I'll keep this like a logic type puzzle, I guess, until I finish it. We'll see. I don't know. Thanks for watching. Bye.